Hi, this is Lonna Lisa Williams. I'm wearing my pink pin because I'm a cancer survivor. I survived cancer in my breast and wrote two books about it. Anyway, I'm not here to talk about breast cancer or surviving cancer or chemotherapy or losing all your hair. I'm talking about moving. Yeah, so I want to show you the hotel I've been staying at in Ontario, California, which is just a bit east of Los Angeles and has a really big airport. This hotel is near the airport and it's called the Ontario Airport Hotel and Conference Center, not to be confused with the Ontario Airport Inn, which is the place I'm going to next because it's a little less expensive. But I got a really good deal in this nice hotel where I have been before with my daughter Jessica. In fact, we spent Christmas here in this very hotel 2 years ago. Yeah. So I'm going to show you around my room. Hope you're having a good day and I hope you don't have to move. I have to move because for the second time in a few months, during the COVID-19 pandemic in the world, I had a mean landlady tell me I had to go. I paid the rent on time. I didn't make any messes. I wasn't loud. I didn't yell at anyone. But I guess I just can't live with another woman. yeah, I don't know. It's just this thing. So I can't really live with a man either until my fiance, Jose of Mexico, gets out of prison and we can be together. Then I will live with a man. In the meantime, I don't know, guess live on my own or whatever. So I'm in this hotel room on my own and I'm getting ready to move again. And how was your 2020? Mine, I had two total knee replacement surgeries, moved twice, well, almost the second time, was evicted by mean landladies. What else? You know, we all know it wasn't a very good year. I'm sure there's something else that goes in twos, but anyway, I hope your COVID-19 2020 was better than mine, and I hope it all ends soon for all of us, and 2021 is a whole lot better. So this is my hotel room and a little bit of a little view of Ontario, California. It's kind of smoggy out, so you can't really see the mountains in the distance. Maybe you'll see a little. Here we go. So this is my hotel on the room on the fourth floor, and there's like a, I don't know, there's a some kind of roof, and in the distance maybe you can see a little bit of the San Bernardino Mountains. It's really smoggy, you can see them barely, and there's some palm trees, and in that direction is the airport. I kept hearing airplanes take off early this morning. So this is my room. Yeah, it's a nice room, actually bigger than any room I ever rented in California. Big old king size bed I was in alone, and it has a nice desk. It has nice art. Here's some nice art, and you can join it with another room to make it bigger. Nice desk, and nice TV with some premium channels. Big old comfortable bed, and there's all my stuff waiting to get finished packing. Try to be organized. I'm gonna start a survival woman series, and maybe this will be my first one. I came to Ontario to meet my daughter, Jessica, to be my camera woman, but she got tied up and she can't be my camera woman right now. So I'm going to do it by myself. So this is my bag of stuff, all of my toiletries for the bathroom in a nice plastic bag. You don't have to spend much. This is even the great value version, the cheap Walmart kind, but it's strong and it works. And then I have my buy my bed bag with all the nose medicine I need because I have terrible allergies. And I have a little bag of stuff I got from the hotel, like shampoo and soap. You get the idea. More bags. I bring my Bible with me because I take it everywhere. I just read about the Good Samaritan, who is our neighbor. Pretty sure that would be everybody. So why is this woman I live with kicking me out? Doesn't she see me as a neighbor? I guess not. There's my computer, which I never opened because I just didn't feel like working. My coats, I brought a lot of coats because, you know, you never know. And a lot of scarves over there. You never know how many coats you're going to need. It's been pretty cold here. Then I've got all these really cool bags that I bought at Sam's Club. And they're definitely worth it. They're $7. and they are so worth it. You open them up and inside they've got this really cool tinfoil like lining, and you can put food in them and they're waterproof. But I found them so big and helpful. See how big they are? Like that I ended up putting everything in them. So I got three. Unfortunately, I only come in two colors, so I have two of the same color. I put like snacks in that one that don't need refrigeration, and in this one, my clothes. Yeah, I brought more clothes. Okay, there's the trash. I brought my own food because you know that's the way to go. Then here's the cute little coffee maker on the back side. There's the door, and it has a nice mirror. Hi, hope y'all are doing good. And a nice closet. Let's open the closet. Ooh, yeah, you got ironing board. You got really cool hangers. I mean, these are so cool. And they're specially designed so you cannot take them home because they would not fit on a normal hanger thing. You've got a safe in case you need to lock up your stuff. I never really left the room, so didn't have to. And of course, the bathroom. It's cool. It's got art. Nice big tub with a shower. Got my towel hanging up there. And a really cool, I took the Kleenex, put it on the bed, really cool little sink area with soap and a lot of towels and extra toilet paper. And over here is the little bar area with a coffee maker and cups, and I put all the coffee on the bed because I'm going to take it with me. I'm going to get some more ice to put in those Costco bags, keep it cold for the food. You've even got cabinets under there. So I really like their room, and you've got lots of dressers. See the dressers there? And over here, you've got dressers under the TV. So there's another dresser over there. I really like it because it's spacious and not too expensive, and it's near a major airport. So, you know, it's got food even you can order up to your room. So welcome to, I'm going back to so you can see me. Welcome to Survival Woman. That's me. I survived cancer. Yep. 25 years ago, when my son was just a baby, lost all my hair, four months of chemotherapy, surgery. I kept most of my boob. They just took out a little lump, thank God. Yeah, but one's kind of smaller than the other, but who cares? So I survived cancer, and I wrote two books about it, and I don't have my books with me, but you can find them on Amazon. Crossing the Chemo Room is the first one, because Chemo Room is not a lot of fun, but you can cross it. And the second one is called I Saw You in the Moon. And the third one is about how I went to Russia to teach English in the winter. And it's called Fire and Ice. And then from Russia, I went to Turkey for 2.5 years and then to China for 2 years. So it starts my adventure series. And I have two books about Turkey. And I have sci-fi and fantasy for girls with strong girl characters. Yeah. Fighting witchcraft. Kind of anti-Harry Potter. Yeah, with a girl as the main character. Her name is Selah. Yeah. And the other girl, her name is Miranda, and she's in a sci-fi book. She doesn't have to fight, you know, witchcraft, but she has to fight bad guys too. So I'm going to say goodbye. Thanks for listening in. Survival Woman has arrived. Watch out for my new videos. I will show you lots of hints on how to survive as a woman alone in this world. Me, I'm in Southern California. It's so expensive. So finding a place to move to, very expensive. I've been considering South Dakota. They don't have a mask mandate. Oh yeah, my mask is over here. I didn't show this to you. They don't have a mask mandate where you have to wear a mask to go anywhere. They don't have that in South Dakota. They don't even have lockdowns or forced quarantine where the churches can't meet inside a building or sing. Our governor, Gavin Newsom in California, made it illegal to go inside a building for church and illegal to sing. Is that violating our United States Constitution and our human rights? Is it? Yeah, I think so. So I've been considering South Dakota, but because Jose is in California, my daughter Jessica is in California, probably I will stay and make the best of it. Right. So I'm going to put my sunglasses on. I'm going to pack up the rest of my stuff. I'm going to go. And I'm going to tell you women out there, because mostly guys do this stuff, how you can survive alone even in California, where it's expensive and you're waiting for your man who's in prison and you're going to wait as long as it takes. I'm going to tell you how to do it. So let's go. This is Survival Woman signing off. Have a good day, and may Jesus richly bless you. Bye.